Okay, so this is the new section for clothing, for units 9 to 11, for Vali. This will be discussing the clothing, how I do the clothing, different ways to sculpt the folds, and how I got to this stage. So, this was quite hard, not hard, time consuming, more like. So there's a lot of technical things that I had to do. There were some things I had to solve. For example, I needed to experiment with how I could export the model and render it in Maya, and try and get realistic skin look. Right now, the skin doesn't look right. It's because I'm gonna redo it and make it modified. So, yeah, right now, what I'll be getting into after this explanation will be the poly paint. If I zoom in here, you can see that I've used cavity masks and various colors to create leather. Now I'm just painting those fake shadows, creating variation in the model so it's not flat like the skin, because I'm going to be exporting through Decimation Master and using poly paint as textures. So yeah, that's basically what I'm doing right now, but I'll be explaining how to do clothing quickly before I continue with the rest of the video. Let me just turn my tablet on. Using this feature on Zbrush called Extract, which allows you to make new geometry based off a mask that you create. I'll give you an example for this bit here. I'll just redo that. So turn on what you want. I just mask a square section. This could be done for t-shirts as well. So if I delete that, it's not model. Mask. Let's see there. There and there. That's good enough. So now I can press extract, press accept. Same thing, extract it and then fill it with the color. So this was the extract stuff was done for every single bit of clothing. You can see here for this leather strap, it was just a masked lasso around that area. trousers, we're done like that. The boots, belt as well. And pretty much everything was done through that. And then position it, sculpt it to how I want it to look. And poly paint with it as well. Buckle was used, was a IMM insert mesh. I believe it was IMM clothing. Yeah, it was this one here, buckle. .02. But yeah. And the clothing detailing was same process, skin detailing, grab an alpha with the standard brush. Drag rect, get an alpha, and then just drag it, of course more precise and with actual leather. If you see over here, this whole section, this part wasn't sculpted. Was using a feature, surface noise, edit, press alpha, find this weave alpha that I used, this isn't the right one, but you can see that it loops this, like, mask, it loops the alpha around where you've masked. And I've done that to create this weave, of course adjusting all of these things as well. So I want to show you how it looks when it's rendered so far. So this is it rendered, that's the look I'm going to have, of course with better colours, better textures, more refined detail. It will look 100 times better when that's done, but with this render you can get the idea that this model is a warrior and he's strong. I hope the audience can realise that when it's animated and rendered. I hope that what we've talked about is clear, and I hope you understand how I've managed to sculpt this clothing. Of course, what I did in this was very, very quick, but that quick procedure, it can be refined to take about a week to create this, and it's not even done. And this was a week's worth of sculpting for me. So, there's a lot more things I need to do to it. But yeah, let's get into the video.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so this is the end of the video. Just a brief of what we've done with everything today. So today we continued with the clothing. As you can see here, we did the lower body, we did the leather pelt, I guess. We were just adding more folds to this section of the clothing, making it more believable. We've done detailing with fabrics. We've used fabric alphas to create these textures, these amazing textures. I love how this looks. I've learned off of like a couple old projects that I've done, so I've realised what things I need to fix, what things I need to change and study more on, and I've learned a lot more from this project as well. For example, the skin here isn't exactly realistic, but it does give you an idea that this character has is not smooth, is very rough, and I feel like these details kind of link to his past, and I feel like you can create more of a story with this appearance. So the rough skin detail is part of the design, I guess. It helps me present the character as a fighter. These Norse tattoos show that he has, he's come across a new mythology or a new pantheon, and he wants to escape his past, but he can't. Of course, he's got his symbol here from birth, so he can't really escape it, and he's trying, perhaps maybe he's covering it up with different tattoos, but to be fair, these tattoos are symbols of power, and it creates more of kind of a story, and it's all linked into the backstory of the character development, so you can kind of see why these are here. So yeah, but apart from the tattoos, skin painted it new. I wanted to make it a bit more dark, because he's not exactly human. Well, he's human, but at the same time he's not, so I kind of want to mix the two, give him human skin, kind of darken it a bit, make it more dark, to kind of show his dark past, and he's got a father that is Lucifer, so I want to link some kind of thing through his actual appearance, which I've mentioned a lot, but I feel like it's important for you to understand that this isn't just a random thing I've done, it is for a reason, and it's part of the design. So, again, in the video I mentioned about Mars by Cavi, and this was done through the polypaint process, so just to quickly explain it. So if you see here, you have skin detail, right? So to mask by cavity will mask those details. If I go to masking here, mask by cavity, you have cavity profile. I've set it to -48 for this one, because if I have it to normal one, you don't get it with the details. So I'm just going to, yep, that's good enough. Mask by cavity. It masks all those details, you invert them, and you can just paint them after. But yeah, other than the body, we've poly painted everything else as well. See here, I've kind of painted in those shadows to make it more believable. Here as well, so you can really see that there's heft to these models. Leather texture's been painted, wool fabric, weaving of the fabrics as well. A lot of detail has been shown through the painting, so yeah, I didn't really want to use substance. I was planning to, but I feel like that's just a waste of time, and there's a lot more things you need to change. Well, here you can just literally add colour by colour by colour, and then just blend them in. So, plus it's all hand painted, nothing taken from a library, which is pretty cool. I'm happy with it. First time really using polypaint, so yeah, even here, like the leather weave kind of texture on the shoulder pad is shown, of course, by the painted shadows, so you can really see that. Even for the flat colour, it's not flat. There's a variety in the texture, and that's what I was looking for. I hope this is what you wanted. No, sorry. I hope you like the model, and I hope that a lot of people like this, and if there's anything I can change, let me know. I'm pretty sure I'll have this done in time for the project deadline, so I'm not worried about that anymore. But I think the last thing I need to kind of focus on is the rendering and the editing for the camera animations in Maya, and you'll see that later on YouTube, hopefully by the end of this week, if not next week. But yeah, thank you for watching.